Did you know that you can actually restore a Yoroi wallet inside Eternl and have it as a new wallet in Eternl? Really easy, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So we start by opening up the Eternl app, and it looks the same on the desktop and the phone. So no matter how you're doing it, just follow this same process. Go to Add Wallet, and then don't go to Import, go to Restore Wallet. Now it's going to ask you how long your key phrase is, and you can actually see from the side here it's going to be either a 15 word or a 12 word, normally 15 word for your eye. So have a count of how many keywords you got and then select the right one and then select next. Now you need to enter your key phrase. I hope you wrote it all down properly. I've got mine here. It's been sitting in my fireproof safe because I'm a good boy like that. If you haven't done the process of recovering a wallet before, it's really simple. You just need to start typing in the word. It'll come up with suggestions down the bottom, and then you just need to click that and then do that another 15 times. So give me a second and I'll be right back. Okay, so I filled in all the words. Just get rid of that. Don't worry, I've changed a few of these words, so you're not going to be able to guess what my key phrase is. And then you just need to click continue. This is my own personal wallet, so you can rename it whatever you want. I'm just going to call it Dave's Wallet. So original and inspiring. And then you need to enter your spending password. You can keep it the same as your eye if you want, so it's the same across both, or you can come up with a new one. So I'm just going to enter this now, so give me a second. Okay, I got my password in. I reckon my password's weak, but a random chain of numbers and letters and symbols. Who the hell's going to guess that? Okay, so now you just need to click save. You can choose the amount of accounts you want. With each account, you can delegate to a new stake pool from your same wallet. So that can be really handy, but the more accounts you have, the slower your wallet will load. I'm just gonna keep it as one because I'm just gonna be delegating my ADA to Upstream. Click save, and then it's gonna restore your wallet. And at first you might think it doesn't come up with your staking straight away, but it soon comes through. But you can see here, look, scroll down, shows you all your staking activity. Even if you set it up in your Yoroi wallet, you can go onto your token list and it's pulled through all your tokens as well, so you can have a look at those. It hasn't pulled through the images just yet though. Oh, there we go. So it's pulled through every single detail from your Yoroi wallet, and you don't need to change anything, so you can actually have it in two places at once. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have, make sure you give this video a like. It really helps spread the message of our channel. And if you like our content, make sure you slap that subscribe button and stay up to date with our weekly content. Got a couple more videos for you here. If you want a detailed walkthrough of the Eternl wallet, check out this video. Or there's a random sort of video that I haven't chosen which one it is yet. Click this one here. In the meantime, grab your paddle and head upstream.